What's going on, everybody? Welcome to episode 26 of our Atalanta Career Mode. And today, we start a new season and a lot to do. Last episode, we talked about what we would do in the squad transfer-wise. And we're going to discuss it a little bit more today. A variety of different things. We were looking at right wing. Free up Hatsibor and Tavares to really handle this right back position. Left back, so we can have Kasace and another left back. We have Gossens at the moment, but having Gossens up here or having the ability to, you know, move around, have depth along the front line would be a little bit better. And then we thought striker, Barrow, Muriel, both in the squad. Zapata has left to Atletico Madrid, £30.9 million. We could have got more, yes, but it was accidental. And then one more in midfield to see what would happen. And then see how we can really shore up midfield in that direction. As you can see, we have a ton of players here. An absolute ton. These are all players who have come back from their loans, and we have a lot to deal with. Only one for the moment is for sure staying, and it is this man, Mancini, who will be jumping into the starting lineup ahead of Popov, I believe. Probably. We'll hold off. Unfortunately, that pace, again, it's wild, the pace. but once we get the pace up, he'll be a proper good player to have around. But for the moment, Simicon and Popov will control that portion. But a lot of other players here are going to have to be moved on, going to have to be dealt with. But we do have a couple of new players in. And as you can see, one of them being Nubel, the goalkeeper. As you can see, Gallini's probably a better player at this moment in time, but Nubel should grow into that position. And then we have a player who can play behind Atarin or in the midfield if we need him to be, Kovalenko from Shakhtar. 24 years of age and should be a really good depth option for us here. And he's got some pretty decent stats there, including that 90 stamina, which we're going to love around here because stamina is an issue around here. 55 stamina for Barrow, now that I've just noticed. But it's one of those things we're going to have to deal with. We're going to have to move forward with and try and figure out how to go. But a lot of things to change here. A lot of players have to go out. Might as well just go through the squad kind of thing, the squad hub, and take a look at who and what will stay. Now, a few issues here. I think we're gonna add Gallini to the transfer list just to see how things go. Sportiello can definitely go. This lad here can go. This lad here, he's only 20. We're going to add him to the loan list, Karneshi. And then this guy can be added to the loan list. We think we're going to keep Berisha around here as the backup to Nubel. And hopefully Nubel, you know, grows into what we think he's going to grow into. So that position dealt with. This lad, 25 years of age, 68 overall, he can go. He is still on loan, this one. But we have a few here who can go. This lad can probably go. We're pretty good at center back with these. Sutalo, Toloi, Simicon, Popov, Mancini. I think we're good with them. These two can leave. We have to also make space to bring players in. We're at that moment in time where players will not join unless we move some on. Alessandro can go. Shibora, we talked about, can leave, though he was all right last year. This lad here can go. We have a lot of players who can go, really. This lad, Pessina, can go. Malinowski stays. This guy here can go. Haas, 24, can leave. Robertson, Mandragora, Draxler, staying. Mattiello, 24, 73 overall, can go. Capone, 21, can go. Silvera can go out on loan. One of our players, I don't remember if he gets really good or not. I think he was accidentally bought up. This lad here can get good. Piccoli, we're going to find him a loan spot. Vito, he can go. There are a lot of players here. Loan list for Traore, why not? Coley can go. Barrow can stay, and this lad here can go. So we have a lot of players going to go in and out of this club. Now, as for budget, $95 million. We have a ton of money here. A ton of money. After that sale, a ton of money. It's just a ton of money. There's no other way to put it, and we're going to have a lot of players going out of the club. Now, let's take a look at what we've done here. I've looked at a couple of players for those four positions. Left back, midfield, right wing, striker. There are a variety of players on here. At left back, we have a couple of players here that I've chosen in the idea that they can be moved on once Kasace really takes over that role. Diego Rico, he's 27. As you can see, the oldest or the youngest is 25 here. Emerson from Chelsea, he can play left back or left midfield. Bensabani from Mönchengladbach, he can play center back theoretically. We don't need him to, but a left back, 79 overall. Not a bad option at all. Stamina 79, stamina here 74, 78 stamina. It's imperative that we took a look at the stamina. Diego Rico, left back, 27 years of age at Bournemouth, $9 million. I mean, that's not a ton of money. Masuaku, he's just joined, so we can kind of get rid of him, but he's always a pretty good option to have, Masuaku. Bensabani, 16 million, and Emerson, 14 million, so you know, there are some decent players on that list at left back. We also have some other left back options from last year that we can always bring in as well. Frattasi, Italian. I've clicked on the wrong lad. Iago, left back. Frattasi's the midfielder. Iago, left back, can also play left wing. 79 stamina is good. Mykolenko from Kiev, 10 million. At the moment, Mykolenko, I think, is the option. Oliveira here, not too bad. Can play left back or left wing, actually. 80 stamina, pretty quick. Maybe he's the option, Oliveira, at the moment. But there are a couple options there at left back. As for midfield, we have a variety of players from last year that I'm still very much interested in that case, and here are some of them. Rocca, Nicolas Dominguez, who joined last year there at Bologna. Rocca, not bad. Exposito, not too bad. Stamina 71, there's not a lot of pace in there. Goncalves, 77 overall. We can pay his release clause at 23 million. Not awful or anything like that. 78 stamina, pretty quick in midfield. Strength isn't great, but we're looking for a player outside of, you know, we'll have Malinovsky and Mandragora on one side kind of deal, and then a Robertson and another kind of shifty midfielder on the other. Goncalves can definitely fit that spot. And then we have a couple of center backs down here, but there are some good midfielders there. And then Kovalenko, of course, who's just shown up, but there's another one here, Frattasi. Proper good player. Nkuku, someone I like to play a little bit deeper, could be a really good option. He can play across the spine and in general. Renato Sanchez, another shifty kind of midfielder who likes to move around. Is Renato Sanchez the man at the moment? That's kind of my guy for now. Guillermo has just joined his club for 2 years in a row now, which is kind of annoying. But Renato Sanchez is a really good option. That's kind of where I'm leaning right now, so we'll actually see. At right wing, Brahim Diaz. He's a weird option in real life. He left City because he wanted to play a little bit more, and then he moved to Real Madrid and didn't really play because, you know, he's 19, and you got to kind of work those players in. So maybe he's interested in moving again so he can play a little bit. We'll see. Galeno, the Braga winger, not too bad. Look at those pace stats, very nice. Calvin Stengs, who's just moved to Villa last year, but we can still bring him in. 19 million, pretty quick. Stamina's okay. We're going to have to work on some things with him. Martin Terrier is a little more of a left-sided kind of player, so is Depay. But if we could move if we could shift the line over, we can. We'll move Vatarin out to the right, and then Draxler down the middle, and then Depay or Terrier kind of in an option there on the left, though 55 million is probably a little bit much. Coutinho will always be an interesting option because he just needs a home, doesn't he? Giovanni Reyna can play it on the left. Won't move again, even though he starts in the game there. So a variety of spots on that right-hand side, or a variety of players on that right-hand side. Irving Lozano is someone who's already touted to be leaving Napoli in real life. Maybe we can keep him in Italy, though 31 million is quite a bit. He is 24, but look at that pace. Absurd pace. And he's got some really good stats about him as well. And then, of course, some of the other ones we held on to from last time. Tete, another Shakhtar player. Pretty quick, as you can see. Stamina needs a little bit of work. Holzek can play all along the front three. Sparta Prague, he's only 17. 76 overall, not bad at all, obviously. Has a, you know, he's very, very well-rounded for his age. Can really excel in a couple of things. And then Samuel Kalou, the Nigerian from Bordeaux, some really good stats. Look how quick this lad is. So we're going to have a lot to think about. And then striker. I wanted to go big name at striker, and we've got a couple of big names at striker at the moment. Giovanni Simeone at Fiorentina, not too bad in himself, though, 24. Daniel Malin is someone we just put on the list, though he's just moved really to United last year. That seems a little bit unrealistic. Patrick Catrone, someone who's left Wolves in real life, still at Wolves in the game. He's still out on loan, it says, so maybe he's still in at Fiorentina, so we'll see about that one. This lad right here, Renier, a lot of you have told me about him. We can activate his release clause at 14 million. A really good prospect here, someone I kind of want to bring in, but I want to get the other options dealt with first. If we have money left over for Renier, we will probably go for Renier. Striker as well. Divock Origi, 15 to 21 million, not a bad option. Can play forward or left, though not really likely to grow from here. Osimhen, a really proper good player. If we can approach to buy, seemingly it seems that we can go below his 32 million pound release clause. 81 overall, 21 years of age, incredibly athletic. Look at him, 86 stamina, 94 speed, 87 acceleration. There are some proper good stats in there physically. Andrea Belotti, who's just seemingly moved to Arsenal this year, so we're going to get him out of there. Moussa Dembele, always on the board, seemingly, for any striker. Proper good, incredibly quick, well-rounded. Look at those physical stats down there. 84 jumping, 85 stamina, 91 strength, 84 reactions, 87 sprint speed. A very, very well-rounded player, though pretty expensive. And then Luka Jovic, really expensive, but maybe worth a punt if you can get him a little bit cheaper at Real Madrid. Not really clicking there, so it's a lot to think about, guys. And today we're probably not going to be doing too much of the transfers. We've really just set ourselves up for the time going forward. We're going to go into training really quick and make sure everybody kind of gets their stuff settled. We're going to go to Mancini here and train his sprint speed. Here we go, sprint speed. That's on easy, though. Stamina's on 76. I kind of just wanted to get his sprint speed up there. Stamina's not too awful for what it is right now. Who else did we want to get training? Do we want to get Cunha training? Maybe not just this moment yet. We're going to get your stamina and speed up. Where are we looking? Race against the clock. Don't want his agility. We're just looking for, where is it? Obstacle shooting. Just looking to keep up the pace. Oh, it's right at the beginning here. So sprint speed, stamina. We're going to get Mandragora on that just a little bit more. He's doing pretty well in that spot in terms of that particular thing. Ataran, we're going to continue to get his stamina going. It's only at 67 still. We'd like that a little bit more. He's going to be very good, and we can hopefully get that rolling in the right direction still. Popov, like to get him also moving in the right direction in that term. 68 stamina, not the quickest. We got to get that moving in the right direction. And then Nubel will keep hold. He should just get better. And then Tavares will move forward with stamina as well. So a lot to think about. I want you guys to let me know who you think we should really go for down there in that list. It's a very extensive list. If you have anybody as well you want to add on to it, go ahead. But this is really just setting ourselves up to really go forward into the new season. And hopefully we can get some money from sales. We have $100 million to spend. We have money to spend. But we also want to spend it wisely and don't really oversaturate the team, I guess. We don't want to go crazy in that term. There's a lot of player chats. I'm glad you decided to sell me. You're welcome. Surprised a bit. I'm just going to... A variety of things, though. Gallini. I wanted to say I was a bit surprised. I've really enjoyed my football. I'm just exploring. Just let him know. Glad we're aligned. I'm just and then everything else is ready to roll. So we're in a good spot money-wise, and hopefully we should be going forward into this season with a deeper team, a more athletic team, hopefully, and we shall see going forward. And we're going to end it right after this loss to Sevilla. See if we're going to jump to the next game, see if any offers come in. We have a lot of players ready to move out, so hopefully eventually some of that comes our way and we really, you know, pick up some of that cash windfall, as well as the wage. Getting the wages off the wage bill would obviously be huge. So here we have a transfer offer for Haas and Radunovic. Let's see if we can, we're just gonna auto do these. We're gonna delegate, do it around there. That's just extra cash. And then Haas, we're going to delegate that. And we'll see what happens going forward, guys. But this transfer window is going to be very liquid, kind of like the January window was. We're just going to go forward and, you know, take it step by step and see where we end up, really. But for now, we're going to end it here as an offer comes in for Mancini. But Mancini will not be going anywhere. I think he's a good option to have. Once we get that pace up to a relatively good level, we should really have a proper good player on our hands. But guys, that's going to be the end of this episode. I hope you folks have enjoyed it. Stay tuned for more. In peace.